गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रेन. वी वर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट सेल्स इन आवर प्रीवियस क्लास एंड वी लर्न दैट देर आर डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ सेल्स. सेल्स कैन डिफर इन देयर शेप एंड साइज डिपेंडिंग अपॉन द फंक्शन दीज सेल्स हैव टू परफॉर्म. एंड वी ऑल्सो डिस्कस्ड अबाउट यूनिसेल्युलर ऑर्गेनिज्म विच कैन चेंज इट्स शेप. विच इज दैट organism? Surya, Suryadev, name the unicellular organism that can change its shape.
An amoeba.
How do they change its shape? With the help of what? What helps them to change its shape? Navaneet? Who can tell me the answer?
Ceramics, false meat.
They have got false meat or pseudopodia. These are some projections arising from its body, and depending upon the requirement of the organism, these pseudopodia will be put forth in different directions. And there are two major functions performed by pseudopodia. Navaneet, can you tell me the two functions performed by pseudopodia? Navaneet, you should read your textbook and come the next day. We are meeting after 1 week. If you can't say Navaneet, you have to say I don't know. Otherwise, I won't understand whether you are hearing my question or not. Navaneet, I'm waiting for your reply. I know you can hear because movements I can see. So let me know whether you know the answer.
I don't
know. Okay. Vaishnavi, what are the two functions performed by pseudopodia?
Ma'am, it helps amoeba to move and capture food.
It helps in movement and also for capturing the food. I want Navaneet to repeat these two points.
Pseudopodia helps amoeba to move and capture the food.
Pseudopodia help amoeba to move and capture its food. Okay. And we also learned about a cell present in our body which can change its shape. Ken, which cell in your body can change its shape? Don't search for the answer. First you unmute. Which is a cell present in your body? I'll give you a clue. This cell is present in your blood.
Ma'am, white blood cells.
White blood cells. They can change its shape. Okay, let's continue. More about the shape of cells. Different cells have different shapes. That I already told you, all cells are not identical. All cells are not similar in their shape. They have different shapes, and the shape is decided by the function it has to perform. For example, blood. Blood is spherical. Red blood cells are spherical in shape. Nerve cells are long and branched. Muscle cells. Different types of muscle cells are there. These are smooth muscles. You will learn in 9th standard. So a particular type of muscles are shown here. They are spindle shaped. Spindle shaped means pointed at both ends. Tapering at both ends. Second figure. Spindle shaped muscle cells. So spherical blood cells. Spindle shaped muscle cells, long and branched nerve cell. So different cells are having different shape, and these shape will enable them to carry out their function. Generally, the cells will be round, spherical or elongated. Some cells can be long and pointed at both ends, as we said in the case of muscle cell, and some can be long and branched, as in the case of a neuron or a nerve cell. Your nerve cell, you know about nerve cell, no? Yes or no, children? Where are nerve cells found? Can anyone tell me where are these nerve cells found?
Nerves.
Huh? Pardon?
Nerves.
Nerves, okay. See, but these nerves are different parts of your body like brain, spinal cord, nerves. All these are made up of nerve cells or neurons. And what function do they perform? They will receive and transfer messages. Nerve cells will help you to, or help your body to receive messages from different parts and to transfer these messages to different parts. And this will help in bringing about control and coordination of different parts of the body. Your body is able to, the different parts of your body can be controlled and coordinated with the help of nerve cells. I'll repeat once again, nerve cells are long and branched and their function is to receive and transfer messages, thereby helping to control and coordinate the different working of different parts of our body. It can be asked, which is the longest cell in your body and what is its function? So you should write, nerve cell is the longest cell in our body and what function do they perform? They receive and transfer messages, thereby helping to control and coordinate the working of different parts of our body. A group of nerve cells will form nervous tissue. In class 9, you will learn, and it is these nervous tissues which are present in brain, spinal cord, etc. Okay, so now you need to know only the function of nerve cell. In very simple sentence, they have given the function of a nerve cell. Nerve cells will receive and transfer messages. What for? To control and coordinate the working of different parts of our body. I'll repeat once again. Nerve cell will receive and transfer messages. What for they are receiving and transferring messages? To bring about control and coordination of working of different parts of our body. Hope you have learned. Now moving on to the next slide. Here you can see. Yes?
Sure, the previous one.
Okay. And one more thing, what you should know, very important point is that the size of an organism has got no relation with the size of the cells present. Size of an organism is not related to the size of the cells in its body. I'll give you an example. Take the case of an elephant. Isha, can I change the slide? Isha?
No, ma'am.
Okay, carry on. So if you compare an elephant, take the case of an elephant and a rat, which is bigger, elephant or rat?
Elephant.
Children, elephant, definitely elephant is big. So do you think that the cells present in an elephant will be larger in size and that present in rats will be smaller in size?
No.
No. Cells will be more or less of the same size in an elephant and a rat. Then what is different? What makes the elephant big and the rat small? Any guess? You said the size remains the same. Then what is different in a huge quantity animal and small animal? Yes?
Quantity.
Very good. The number, the quantity, the number of cells. Elephant consists of, or the body of an elephant consists of many cells. Whereas when compared to the number of cells in an elephant, the number of cells in a rat, the body of a rat is less. The cells in an elephant are not bigger than those in a rat. The size will be related to the function it has to perform. Definitely the number can be more. If you take nerve cell in an elephant and a rat, both will be long and branched and they perform the same function. What we said just now, transferring messages, receiving messages and controlling and coordinating the working of different parts of the body. Nerve cells in an elephant and a rat are long and branched. Size has got no difference and they perform the same function. But what is different is the number of cells present, which will make the body of an elephant huge and the body of a rat small. Okay, very important point to note. There is no connection with the size of the cells and the size of the organism. The size of the cells has no relation with the size of the body of the organism. And the size is always related to the function it has to perform. Nerve cells present in an elephant and a rat, both are long and branch and carry out the same function, that is transferring messages. But the number of cells can definitely be different. Any doubts? Shall I proceed? Yes or no? I need response from you, only then I can proceed. Do you have any doubts or you want some time to note it down?
Yes.
Okay. Next is about the levels of organization. This you already know. We have learned about it. Cell is a structural and functional unit of all living organisms. But a group of cells, what do a group of cells form?
Tissue.
Tissue. A group of tissues form an organ. A group of organs will form an organ system. And many such organ systems like digestive system, respiratory system, circulatory system, all these systems will together make an organism. Once again, a group of cells will form a tissue. A group of tissues will form an organ. A group of organs will form an organ system. And several such organ system will form an organism. So here the definition of tissue is given in your textbook. A group of cells performing a similar function or a specific function, you can call it as a tissue. A group of similar cells performing a specific function. That group of cells will be similar in appearance and size, and they will be carrying out the same function. A group of similar cells, a group of similar cells performing a specific function. These two points to be noted. A group of cells, a group of similar cells performing a specific function is known as a tissue. If you are asked to define a tissue, rather than simply writing a group of cells, you can write a group of similar cells that perform a specific function. Okay? Cell is a basic structural and functional unit of all living organisms that we had already learned. So before I proceed to the next topic, that is components of a cell or the main parts of a cell, let us see what we have understood, what you have understood. So quickly summarize the points what we said. We'll start with Lakshmi. Today what all points we covered, quickly you can summarize one point. Others get ready, okay, all will get a chance. Yes, Lakshmi.
Ma'am. Ma'am, different cells have different shapes, like body muscles and body, nerve cells.
Okay, body muscles, nerve cells. So different cells are having different shape. What decides its shape, Nivedya? What decides the shape of the cells?
It's decided by the function of the cell.
Function. Okay, good. Which is the longest cell in our body and what is its function, Adigesh? Longest cell in your body and what is its function?
The nerve cell.
What function it performs?
Its functions to receive and transfer the messages.
What for? Why it is receiving and transferring messages?
For the proper working of our body.
To control and coordinate the working of different parts of our body. And then what else we learned? We learned about a few cells and its shape. Can anybody tell me the shape of a few cells? Three, four cells we discussed. Who will tell me? Anybody? Don't wait to call out your name. Three types of cells. You want me to call out the name only, then you will answer? Be confident and say, let it be wrong. You're free to make mistakes, children, as I always used to say. Make mistakes. Yes, Advait.
Nerve cell.
Nerve cell. What is its shape? Advait? Nerve cell, what is its shape? How do they look like? Who can help him?
Ma'am, look like a long branch.
Nerve cell, long and branch. Then few more cells we learned.
Ma'am, muscle cells.
Muscle cells, what is its shape?
Spindle shape.
Spindle shape. Not all muscle cells, but smooth muscles are spindle shape. Then one more we learned. Red blood cells. Spherical. Don't hesitate. When a chance comes, you have to speak out. No problem if you make mistakes. When you make mistakes, you will again, I'll correct you and you will learn from mistakes. Don't hesitate to speak. Okay? Then after that, what did we learn? Once we completed that one important point we discussed. What was that, Advait? What did we learn about? After this, these points, after discussing about the shape of the cells and their function, I told you there is one main point and we discussed in detail about it. What is that?
The size of the cell.
Wait, Henin, I'll give you a chance. Advait? You know? Unmute and say.
Cells of a similar.
Not Advait Sinub, Advait Murali. Okay, speak. Henin, get ready, okay? Advait, unmute. Something we learned about elephant and rat, no, we compared. What was that, Advait?
The cells in elephant are not bigger than those in the rat.
And what is the difference, main difference between them in terms of cells? Elephant will have?
Related to its function.
Okay, but elephant will have? More cells. More cells when compared to a rat, but the size of the cell is more or less the same. Henin, what is the role of a nerve cell in an elephant?
Both in elephant and a rat are long and branched.
Function. Nerve cell, what function it will perform?
Same function of transferring messages.
Yes, very good. They'll help in transferring messages. And there is no such difference that in an elephant, nerve cell is performing some other function and in rat, yet another function. Nothing like that. In both elephants and rats, they'll be performing the same function of transferring messages. The size of the cells will be more or less the same in different organisms, but the number of cells can vary. So now we are going to learn about the different components of a cell. A cell is having three main components. Anybody know? Can anybody say the different components have you heard about? In a cell, the different parts, have you learned before? No. Okay. So a cell is having three main components and these are cell membrane or plasma membrane. Cell membrane or plasma membrane. Then cytoplasm. And the third one, the most important part, nucleus. Cell membrane, cytoplasm, and nucleus. Cell membrane or plasma membrane, then cytoplasm, and the third one, nucleus. Cell membrane, you can even call it as plasma membrane. Plasma membrane or cell membrane, nucleus and cytoplasm. And we'll be learning about each of these components in detail. Cell membrane or plasma membrane, cytoplasm and nucleus. We'll begin with the first one, that is cell membrane. What is the other name for cell membrane? Plasma membrane. You all should note down the points. And when I ask you the questions, don't hesitate. Quickly you have to say. I'm not calling out the name so that all will get a chance. So whoever is able to answer, immediately unmute and speak. When it is asked, when I'm calling out a name of a particular student, he or she can answer. Otherwise, when a question is asked in general, don't hesitate waiting for me to call out any names. Okay. You need to perform better in terms of response. I know you all are very smart children, but when some question is also asked, you should be very prompt in answering. Cell membrane, cytoplasm and nucleus are the three components. So let us start with the first component, that is cell membrane. So we are going to learn different functions of cell membrane. And here I have given the picture of a typical animal cell. And you can see the outermost boundary of an animal cell is made up of cell membrane. Cell membrane or the plasma membrane will enclose the cytoplasm and the nucleus. We learned there are three components. And out of that, the cell membrane will be enclosing the other two components. See, this is cytoplasm. This one is nucleus. So cytoplasm and nucleus. So this is cyto. You will know what is meant by cytoplasm. I'm not explaining about it now. And this one is nucleus. And nucleus and cytoplasm are enclosed by what? The cell membrane. Cell membrane will enclose both nucleus and cytoplasm, which means that the boundary, the border is cell membrane. Within that, there'll be nucleus and cytoplasm. So that is the first point. Moving on to the second point. It will separate cells from one another and also from the surrounding medium. This is just one cell. So if there are many cells, just imagine so many cells are there. So who is separating these different cells? The cell membrane. The cell membrane will separate the cells from one another and also from the surrounding medium. I'll give you an example. Your classroom, so many classrooms are there now, building, isn't it? But how do you find that, or how do you separate out 8A from 8B, then 8B and A from 8C? How do you understand? How do the teachers understand? This room is 8A, the other room is 8B. How do we know? Because of the four walls, isn't it? Some walls are there which will separate one room from the other. It is because of these rooms or these walls that each class is different or separated from other classes, as well as also from the surrounding area. From the surrounding area, this four walls or the walls will separate each room. And it will also separate one room from the other. That is how we are able to understand that this is a particular room, 8A. The other room is meant for 8B students. Am I right? If those four walls, imagine the walls are not there, just a hall. Can we separate out the different classrooms? 8A, 8B, 8C, everything will be mixed up. So it is because of these walls that you can separate one class from the other. Similarly, cell membrane will separate cells from one another and also from the surrounding medium. I'll repeat again. The cell membrane separates cells from one another and also from the surrounding medium. Now, next point about cell membrane. Cell membrane is porous. Porous means it's provided with pores. So in the cell membrane, small openings are there. See, It is not very clearly visible, but under an electron microscope, these pores and all will be clearly seen. Okay, so with a better magnifying microscope, all that can be seen. And scattered in the cell membrane, small, small pores, openings or pores are there. Why these pores are present? For the movement of materials, both inward and outward. If materials from the cell has to move outward, and from outside, if it has to move in, there should be some openings. So only if openings are there, the materials can be exchanged in between the cell and the surrounding medium. So once again, the membrane is porous. Why it is porous? To allow the movement of substances or materials towards the cell and from the cell to outside. For both inward and outward movement of materials, there are some pores present on the cell membrane. But hearing this, you should not think that any material can move in and out of the cell. Cell membrane will not permit. Cell membrane will not allow any material or everything to go in and out. It will allow only selected materials to move in and out. It will allow only certain substances to move in and out. So due to that reason, you call this membrane as selectively permeable. Commonly asked question, why do you call cell membrane as selectively permeable? It selects what material should go in and out. It will be selecting which material should go, which material should not be permitted to go in and out. That is decided by the cell membrane. So we discussed about different functions of cell membrane. So the first function is that it will enclose the cytoplasm and the nucleus. Then it will separate cells from one another and also from the surrounding medium. Then it's provided with pores and helps in the exchange of materials to and fro, both inward and outward. Then one very important point about cell membrane also we learned, it's selectively permeable. What do you mean by selectively permeable? Only selected substances will be allowed to pass through it. Now children, here I have given the picture of a gatekeeper. We have a gatekeeper in our school. Am I right? And just imagine that you are getting bored. Maybe you imagine that you are having regular classes. Okay, and you felt so bored and you want to go home and you want to play. So what you will do? Slowly you will bung the class and you will reach near the gate. Can you go outside? The gatekeeper will permit you to go out?
No.
He will ask for the out pass, whether you're permitted, whether parents have come. So he will verify, and if parents have come to call the ward, then definitely he will permit seeing the outpass. Otherwise, he will send you back and inform the teachers. Similarly, somebody from outside, they want to sell something over here. Okay? And some street vendors, they reach the gate. Will he open the gate for them? Definitely no. He will ask to take prior permission or appointment and then come inside. So without any prior appointment or without informing the authorities or the school office, if somebody is coming just as they pass by, they're coming to sell something, he will not permit. Yes. At the same time, chairman sir has to leave the school for an emergency meeting or somewhere he has to go. So will, let it be 12 o'clock or 1 o'clock, whatever be the time, no need to wait till the school disperses. And if he reaches or his car reaches near the gate, will the gatekeeper open? Yes or no? Yes. And if some parents are coming, they have to pay the fees or take their child back home, will he permit?
Yes.
Yes. So he will check who has to go in and who should not go in. So he is like our cell membrane. So you can compare cell membrane to the security guard, because the security guard will not allow anybody to go in and out of the school. He will only permit selected people to go in and out. Same way, cell membrane will not allow all the materials to go in and out. The cell membrane will select the materials that should move in and out of the cell. Is that clear, children? Are the points clear?
Yes,
so it's what not. Are the three main components of a cell? Fadil, tell me the three main components.
Cell membrane.
Yes.
Cytoplasm. Mm.
Nucleus.
Nucleus.
Okay. So another name for cell membrane I mentioned. Fadil, can you tell me that too? Another yes, name for cell membrane. Yes.
Plasma membrane.
Plasma membrane. Very good. Then we discuss 3-4 functions of cell membrane. So 1 point, Tamanna, I told you not to turn the videos off. Still some are turning the videos. So I'll ask those children first. Yes, Tamanna.
Ma'am, it can move to and fro motion.
Cell membrane will move to and fro. That is what we said. Tamanna, this is what happens when the videos are off, child. You will get distracted. Albert, tell me, Albert, 1 point. Tamanna, you're going
ma'am,
to
cell membrane.
Ah.
Ma'am, cell membrane or the plasma encloses the cytoplasm and the nucleus.
Very good. It will enclose the cell membrane and the nucleus. Tamanna, when you're ready with the point, let me know. Lakshmi CV, another point.
Ma'am, the cell membrane separates the other by surrounding.
Cell membrane will separate cells,
from one another
and also from
the surrounding.
Medium. Will you repeat again?
Medium.
Will you repeat
yes,
again?
The cell membrane separates the cell from the other and also from the surrounding medium.
Very good. Now, point number three. Anybody? I told you, don't hesitate. Yes.
Ma'am, it is a porous. It allows the movements of the substances and also it allows the materials to go outward and inward.
Outward and inward. It is having, cell membrane is having pores on it, or it is porous membrane and helps in the exchange of materials both inward and outward, or movement of materials both inward and outward. One more point. The main point. Yes, Isha.
It is also known as selectively permeable because it doesn't allow everything inside and inward and outward.
It will select. It will allow only selected substances to move in and out. Okay. Clear, children? No doubts, no children in the topics covered today?
No.
We wind up? Okay, children. See you next class.